I could ask you to hold a microphone, is that...
Oh, my... Are you above that these
please,
days?
Could you hold this for me?
I never know. Ringo, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Absolute Radio, here we are. Hey, how you doing? Peace and love.
Are you going to be difficult this morning? Or
no, I'm going to be lovely.
Good. I love you.
You love me.
I do. Can I say, one of the greatest rock drummers of all time, without a shadow of a doubt, and I think that's sometimes overlooked a little bit.
Not anymore. Not since the remasters.
Yeah. Were you in there one day?
Now you can hear the drums.
Were you in there one day? So I'll mix this one, lads, and you push the drums up a bit. And
I did.
Good, as it should be.
I snuck in.
Your fills on Tomorrow Never Knows, and she said, the greatest drum fills of all time.
Of all time? Well, praise indeed.
Now,
and do you play?
I play bass. Luke plays the drums. Luke's a drummer. Play?
Praise indeed.
I'm being totally cheap by Ringo Starr.
Yeah.
Luke, our man's a drummer.
Okay, well, he's not interviewing me. I don't care.
You're all
kidding.
Thanks, Ringo.
I meant that with peace and love.
Should we do the business?
If you must.
We must do, because otherwise Sue will get very...
Why are we here?
We are here because you're All-Starr Band. You're doing your first European tour
in
15, 16
since
years.
Since I did those fills you're talking about. it's been a long time. I don't know, it just sort of... I did Europe in the 90s a couple of times.
Yeah.
And then I just sort of stayed in America.
Why
I don't
come?
Know. Most of the band was, lived there.
Yeah.
And I just found it was easier, really, because, you only have to show your passport once.
Yeah, exactly. That would make sense.
And anyway, we're going to do it this year because I just felt, hey, let's go.
Yeah. You've got a good band as well, as always. As if you didn't have any less.
I do have a good band.
Who have we got? Rick Derringer.
Rick, great guitar. And hang on, Sloopy.
Knocked yesterday off the number one spot. Was yesterday a single in the States?
Probably.
Yeah, they released all kinds of crazy shizzle over there.
I'm not on it, am I?
No, you're not. It's a solo, isn't it?
I took no interest.
So Hang On Sloopy is a great song.
Yeah, it is. No, he's great. Rick is great and he's playing great.
Yeah.
And also we're blessed because we have Edgar Winter.
Yeah.
Who is like the Mr. Rock and Roll of this band.
Yeah.
And him and Rick had played together. So it's nice when the players know each other a little.
Do you say that? How much rehearsal do you have as a band? Or do you just meet up on the first day and go, right, these are the songs. Come on, lads, let's do it.
No, we pick the songs before we get to the rehearsal.
Right, okay.
And, the whole thing about Ringo and the All-Stars is everybody has to have had a hit in the 60s, which I did, in the 70s, which I did, in the 80s and the 90s so far.
Yeah.
So it's like, I like to say in America, it's like the 1-800 number.
Yeah.
Where you phone up on the TV, you can get the record of all the hits. Well, that's what it's like.
How come Weight of the World wasn't a huge hit?
Well.
That was such a good song.
Talk to somebody, brother.
Oh, let's get that reissued and we'll get that in the top 10.
Okay.
They still do the top 10? I don't know.
I don't know either. Well, which top 10 would I be in?
Not the Enemy poll winners.
You know what I mean? There used
party.
To be the top 20 and, there's a little blurb, the top country and the top rock. Now there's there's so many categories.
Yeah.
I don't know where you'd put me.
Who else have we got? He's quite difficult, it turns out.
Hey, I'm not.
You're lovely. Wally Palmer.
Wally Palmer.
I don't know. I don't remember
the
Romantics.
He was the Romantics.
I don't remember the Romantics.
Well, I must tell you because you like music.
Yeah, definitely.
Pull out your Romantic CD from... way back when, and I'm sure Absolute Radio could buy a copy if they don't have it.
I will, yes.
And listen to Wally, What About You, and his songs are, the band was called The Romantics, but his songs are really rocking, so it's good.
Yeah. Is there anyone that you've asked to be in your All-Starr Band, and they've not been able to do it?
Yes.
Are you
only because they, only because they'd set up their own tour, and I didn't know.
Yeah.
So that was all, but nobody just turned me down flat.
Yeah.
Nobody ever did.
Nobody would. It's like getting off of Frank Sinatra or the Mafia or something.
Oh, yeah. I tried Frank, but he just won't return my call.
I've got something to say about Frank later on. You might be a little bit upset.
I've seen it.
He's passed over.
Oh.
He's passed over a while
ago.
Mickey Dolenz from the Monkees, would you ever get him in? That would be awesome.
No,
the
Mickey,
Monkey.
Are you kidding? Get out of here.
Awesome.
Mickey Dolenz. Crap. I believe they're having trouble putting the band together right now. That's why I said that, Mickey. Mickey's a good friend, he'll understand.
That'd be awesome, because you did that Pizza Hut advert with them years ago.
I did years ago, but I wouldn't have the pepperoni because I'm a vegetarian.
Exactly, well
and
done.
And it drove them crazy. You know, pepperoni is the biggest selling pizza in the world. You know, you learn things every day.
Hold that in your mouth, for goodness sake.
Oh, for there God. We go.
So, let's go through some of the dates. You've,
you know, where usually they have a little clip-on thing. It's very
not that
advanced. Unattractive.
What have you got on your badge? I'm trying to work that out. I can't see.
Oh, it's stars and moons.
Oh, lovely, beautiful. Oh. 3D again, holographic.
Yeah, I love holograms.
Mm, very nice. So you've got Ukraine, Russia, Sweden.
We open in the Ukraine, and guess what?
What?
Guess who's family, and he is from Wally Palmer.
He's from the Ukraine?
Yeah.
Really?
His whole family are from the Ukraine, and he speaks the language, so he'll be doing the announcements.
So you're guaranteed to sell that gig out then?
We have. Yeah, we're big in the Ukraine.
Russia, have you sold out Russia?
I don't know about selling out.
Yeah.
I just set up the tour, and then people put it together, and I turn up, and you know, where I come from, yeah. You're just so grateful you could play somewhere. Yeah. It could be 2,200, you know, in the audience we play.
Mm.
That's how we work.
Are you allowed to tell us which ones of your songs you're going to be singing?
Little Help.
Yeah.
Yellow Sub.
Photograph.
Yeah, Photograph. I'll put Photograph in just for you.
Well, listen, I was hoping to come on the 17th of June, but I'm doing a gig with a guy called Barry from Watford. He's an 84-year-old man. Yeah. Any tips on, because I'd rather come and see you if I'm honest. Any tips on sneaking out and...
Oh, you won't even know you've gone.
Really?
No. How old?
He's 84.
84.
It's a gig in Watford. I'd rather come and see the All-Starr Band at Hampton.
Barry, come on.
So I'll just blow him out. You must still enjoy it. You must get a buzz.
I do.
From...
No, it's what I do.
Yeah.
You know, people say, no, you're still doing it. Yes, actually, I am,
yeah.
Because this is what I do.
Yeah.
I'm still doing it with really good players, you know, and people with great songs, and I get a chance with the All-Stars to be down the front doing a Peace and Love and Let's Go Everybody, and then off on the drums to play with everybody else.
And still enjoying the drums as well.
That's what I do.
Yeah.
No, I love the drum.
Your boy's not bad either, is he?
My boy is very, very good.
He's the drummer with The Who.
I think that's
so cool.
Yeah, well now he's the drummer with Penguins, his band.
Oh, really? Good.
You know, and he's... opening for BDI.
Right, okay, yeah, yeah.
Because they're all mates. Because he was with Oasis for 180 gigs.
Yeah.
180.
So you're looking forward to the tour. There's a new album as well, I think, that you've
been
working
on. I've just finished a new album in LA,
yep.
My new CD. And I'm going to mix it starting next week here. And then it'll probably be out in January.
Okay.
I don't have a title for it yet.
No, you no title?
Did you listen to Why Not? The last album?
I listened to some of it.
Yeah, good.
It was good. I enjoyed it.
No, it was good.
Okay. And also, we're finishing the second. So I know you've got busy, David. Do you like doing interviews?
Well, I'm doing it because I'm on, you know, I'm going on tour and I'm letting you know I'm here.
Yeah.
And, you know, also we'll have a record out later.
Yeah. When you should come and do a session for us. Absolutely. Come and
what
do
you mean a session?
Little acoustic.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's going to happen.
Oh, sure. Okay, yeah, I'll be right there.
I was a fucking Beatle. I'm not doing that.
When do you want me?
Anytime.
Oh, no, not anytime.
I'm busy
anytime.
Very briefly, I watched a brilliant documentary about the fantastic Harry Nilsson the other day. Just what a talented man.
Yeah, it was my best friend.
I know, and I'd kind of forgotten about all of the wonderful songs.
Oh, incredible. Besides that, his voice. His voice was the best voice in
the album of standards
at that time. He actually came to the studio to meet the Beatles because we all loved him so much and we couldn't believe how great his voice was.
Yeah.
And his version of River Deep just was so close to going over the edge of madness. It was so great. Anyway, he was a good friend and I miss him still.
Yeah, a great time. I just saw this a couple of weeks ago and thought this is, you know, it's fantastic. Ringo, it's lovely to meet you.
And you,
I wish you the very best. I don't need to wish you the luck with the tour. You're going to storm it, of course you are.
Well, we're going to do it anyway.
But, well, listen, it's lovely to meet you and thank you very much for
all anyway, if you get out of going to Croydon, come on over and see us.
I will see. If I can't do that one, I'm going to come to Bournemouth and see you in Bournemouth.
Bournemouth, great. No, great.
It's great.
I know.
It's great.
Yeah. You know, anywhere we can play. We're still at it. We're still doing it. That's the deal.
Ringo, it's a pleasure.
Anyway, look, I've got to win this because he never will. So peace and love, everybody. Peace and love, brother.
Peace and love, brother.
Yeah.
Thank you, boss.
Yep, these would be great, wouldn't they, boy?
Thank you, Ringo.
Thank you, bro.
It's an absolute pleasure. Ringo, can I ask, where do you stand on signing things? Could we get two CDs signed, or is that a no-no?
I haven't signed because I was signing stuff and it was being sold on. And if you look at eBay, there's lots of guitars I never played, but I went to sign scratchers. So I decided, and it's very difficult some days, that I will not sign. And that's just it. Doesn't mean I don't love you.
Perfectly understood. I knew that was kind of your vibe, and I thought I would.
Oh, you knew that was going to happen. You still have.
This is a once in a lifetime opportunity.
Yeah? It was a once in a lifetime opportunity. I thought it rude not to.
Okay, bye.